Use the section wizard to create new sections and edit the existing ones. To create a new section, go to the System Designer and click the Section Wizard link located in the System Setup block. For example, let's create an Ideas section to contain ideas for company processes and office development. At the first wizard step, specify the main properties for your new section. Upload the section icons to be displayed in the side panel of your application and in the section feed. Specify the section code as the name of the main object to contain the section data. You can specify the name of an existing object, otherwise, the wizard will create a new one automatically. Please note that custom sections must start with the USR prefix. Enter the section name to be displayed on the side panel. You can also specify the workplace that will contain your section, or you can do it later using the System Designer. Our Ideas section will contain records of several types, such as company process ideas and office development ideas. Each type of record will have a dedicated edit page. Select the Several Edit Pages checkbox, and the wizard will create them automatically. The system will automatically define the column for the new section object to store the record type and will create a lookup object for this record type. Use the wizard for the record type values that you want to edit within the created section. The values will be automatically saved in the types lookup created for the record types of your section. To open a section edit page, select the corresponding item from the Pages button menu. By default, a new section page will contain one text field, Name, and two tabs, General Information and Feed. Let's supplement the page with new columns that will contain general information. Add a new description column of the string type that will contain the description of an idea. Specify the column title, name, and string length. Select the multi-string option if you want to create a multi-string entry type field. You can also specify the style of controls, hide the title, and change the font size. You can specify the place on the page for your new field to be located in by increasing and decreasing the field size or expanding it to fit the page width. Then, add an author lookup field to store the contact assigned as the author of an idea. Specify the column name and title. This column will refer to the system contact from the existing object. After that, add a similar owner column to store the information about the contact assigned as the idea implementation owner. Finally, add another column to display the idea development status. Create a new status lookup to store the idea statuses. If you select the Display as drop-down list option, the field data will be displayed as a drop-down list. To set up the second type of page, you can add existing columns to the page, the ones that were added to the object while creating the company process edit page. Add an implementation tab to the office development edit page to store the information about the idea implementation details. Place an idea implementation details field group on the tab. Add two fields to the field group. The first field will be a Boolean type indicating that the budget for idea implementation is approved. The second field will display the idea implementation plan date. At the third wizard step, you can set up the section list. The tile view allows you to arrange the record data in multi-string format within the list. In the list view, the data is displayed in the single string format. You can add and delete columns displayed in each view. When you have finished the setup process, save your section in the system. As soon as the wizard finishes the work, the new section will appear in the All Employees workplace. The section will contain two edit pages that you created to store different types of ideas. The structure of the pages in the list will correspond to the one you have set up using the wizard.